Hey y'all, Surfing Sapo here. Today is Sunday, the last week 17 of the NFL. As far as the date, I have no idea. It is 2013, so try to figure that out for yourself. It's the last Sunday of 2013. Let's go with that, okay, folks? Let's see, how do I start this? I'm going to barbecue today, all right? I'm going to barbecue a Shickon chicken. And let me just show you. And a brisket. USDA Select. This is a 8-pounder, 8.34 pounder at 269 a pound. Comes out to $22.43. Got it at Staple Street Meat Market, Corpus Christi, Texas. I'm gonna rub it with the Chubby's Gourmet Steak Shake. Slammin' steak shake. That's a big steak, right? Y'all know that. Also, one Shickon. This is a whole fryer, 3.23 pounder at $1.49 a pound. Comes out to a total of $4.81. Probably gonna just cut it in half like that. So, gonna cook it on my offset smoker, the stainless steel Texas pit crafter, just because I can, and I feel like feeding it wood all day. It keeps me awake. It's I don't even have a watch anymore. I don't care about time no more, folks. It's irrelevant. But anyway, it's shortly after noon. It's the first game, third quarter of the first game of NFL on Sunday, so take a gander at what time it might be. All right, we'll get started rubbing it, and we'll take her out back and throw it on the offset. See you in a bit. All right, here we have the Shickon. Get some of these scissors right here. Let's come on each side of the neck and just simply cut back. On one side, follow the backbone. Okay, open her up. Now you see what you got right here. Do it on the other side also. Okay. Now this virtually right here is a spatchcock chicken. We might just go with this. In fact, I think I will. Spatchcocked chicken. All right. Then we're going to get some of this, put it in here, Shubby's. We're going to simply shake it on. Nice big pieces, look at that, beautiful. Just like that, doesn't matter. All good, folks. Some more on this side, Shubby's. And there you have it. This we're going to just cook for good measure. Alright, next up, the brisket. Alright, we have the brisket here. Put these scissors out here. You don't need them anymore. Same thing. Sprinkle it on. Rub it around how you want it. Put it everywhere, even where the fat is. It's okay, folks. Mainly on the meat. This is all fat on this side. Protection. A little bit of meat right here. Don't be afraid to use it. Use it, don't lose it. Rub it in. Put some under here. Underarms. Don't forget the underarms. A little bit here on this part. Okay, that's good enough. Ain't gonna stay nohow. Look, somebody messed up. They cut a hole in this brisket. Put some in that hole. That's it. There you have it. A rubbed brisket with Shubby's. Shubby's.
All right, here we have a charcoal chimney. Put some charcoal in there. These are royal oak. We're just using this to get started. So like we always say, let's get started. See that? We're just gonna get them started. Oh, no. Fail. There we go. Another fail. Come on, quit failing. There we go. Third time's a charm, folks. The way you do this till they get going, then we're going to dump them over there, down there in the smoke box. And I'll show you that in a minute. Throw a couple logs in there for good measure. Get it up to temp. We'll lay the brisket out over here. We'll go from there. Just let those get going, see? And then here's the rest of the story. We'll set the brisket up here, probably over here, and put the shickon right there. All right, be back in a minute. Okay, folks, let's take a flyby down here in the firebox. There's the firebox. Kind of see in there, got mesquite and charcoal. So let's go ahead and shut the firebox now. There, let me give you a tour of this pit. This is a full marine grade stainless steel offset pit. Heavy, heavy, heavy. It's all marine grade. You can put a magnet on here, it just falls right off. No metal. This thing's been out. That's rust from laying something like that on top of it. But other than that, there ain't no rust on this thing. It's been out in the weather for 10 years. Another good thing is the smokestack is down there, and it's not way down there, and it's not on the top. It's right below the meat level. So that'll cause the meat to come up, fill up the chamber. Oh, sorry. Come up, fill up the chamber. The smoke, come up, fill up the chamber, then go down, then out. So let's shut this puppy. Just started. We have no heat at all. We're below 100 degrees. Below 50, actually. It's about it. It's wide open. We'll come out over yonder. It's a firebox. You can just lay stuff. Also, let's move some of this stuff. Take a peek at this. This is pretty cool. If you want to make steaks or whatnot, you just open this up. Then you take this piece of heavy-duty iron off there, and there's a grill under there. So I'd like to see that. Pretty cool. Anyway, the smoke's coming out the top now, so we'll start to put the brisket and the shickon on here in just a few more minutes, folks. All right, get back. I'm gone. Let's do what I said. Put the brisket. Could do fat side up, fat side down. We'll do fat side up today. There you go. The brisket's right here. Let y'all get a better look of that. We'll get the brisket on there. Smoke's going everywhere. There you are. Now we set it and forget it, and throw logs in every once in a while. Okay, I got to get the shickon. Be right back. All right, the shickon. Remember where we're gonna put it? Right there, where it's hot. And let it get cooked right here. Put that right there. That'll be nice and hot. That over there. Let y'all look at everything. Don't mind that metal piece. The shickon and the brisket. So we will be checking on this every now and then, more then than now. All right, see y'all then, or now. All right, take a little look at this shickon. Pretty good. Flip her over again. Oh yeah, that's not burnt. That's nice and crisp right here. There's the brisket over yonder. Anyway, quit looking. Get cooking. Well, I just turned it over, folks. I just want to show you what we've got so far. That's the chicken. Looking mighty good, isn't it? And then we're going to look at this brisket up here. A lot of smoke in the way. Well, sorry. That's the brisket. So it's coming along quite well. All right. Quit looking and get cooking again. All right, what I've done here is moved it up to the top rack. That's what it's looking like right now. That's some good looking chicken, folks. And over to the right, we got some good looking brisket. So let's shut this lid and get back to the ball game. Good folks. Okay, let's check the Shickon. I'm gonna take this little gauge here, stick it right in here, not too far. 151, 169, it's ready. She done ready. 170, it's ready, folks. The Shickon is ready to take off and rest and eat. We take the Shickon off with the tongs here. Look at that. Man, those legs are ready to bust out of there. Look at that. Oh, man, it's trying to focus on the this part of it. That's why that looks so dark. Anyway, let's get out of this. Here you are, folks. Coming along. I can't really tell you how much longer. It takes a long time to cook a big chunk of meat like this at such a low temp. So, just letting it go. Alright. Alright. Let's see what we got here with our trusty, handy-dandy thermometer. Just find a nice place to stick it. Set it and forget it. No, don't forget it. It'll burn up. Okay, we're up to 171, 173, about 173. Got about another 10 pounds. 10 degrees, I mean, pounds. This is 10-pound brisket. So about another 10 degrees, folks. All right? Coming along nice. This is going to be a dandy of a brisket. I can tell you that right now. I guarantee it. All right, it's time to take it off. Try to. I can probably just grab it underneath, hopefully. Yeah. And pull it over here onto the pan. It'll take it in the house. Mmm. There we have it, folks. Right there. We'll take it in, let it rest, and then slice it. All right. We have it in the house now. Resting. Let's go ahead and check the temp again. It was up to about 190, and that's good enough for me. 190, let's see. 191. About 192. Can y'all see that? 191, 192, let's see. There you go, 194. That's good enough. It's resting now. This baby's done. Just need to cool off and we'll slice her. Alright, what we have here is a brisket that's been smoked for a number of hours. It's actually early in the morning now. I let it rest all night. Well rested. There's different ways to do this. I'm going to try to do it. When it's hot, it's a lot easier, but you can just scrape if you can find the fat. See, there's very little fat left, so we're not going to worry about that. But just take a little cut of it. See what we got. You'll see the fat right here. See the fat? That's the fat that I was trying to scrape off, but you can cut it off later. It doesn't matter. Get you one of these nice slicing knives. Oh, some nice pieces there. Oh, yeah. Killer bark. Finally got a little bit of a smoke ring. Let's see what we've got right here. There you go, folks. Got your brisket. Got your fat on this side. A little bit of smoke ring. Kind of a little smoke ring all the way around, but it's okay. Cut some for the neighbors. There we go. It's nice, and like I said, it's been sitting out all night, so it's kind of cool. But see, it just pulls apart. Not real easy, but yeah, pretty easy. Anyway, let's taste it, and we'll see what we got, okay?
Alright, it's the next morning, like I said, pretty early. Let's get a chunk and try it out. It's a piece right here, can you see that? Kind of got the line on it. I don't know. You can't see it, sorry. There you go. Can y'all see that? Got fat on this side. I'm going to leave that on there because it's pretty good. Killer consistency. You can taste the beef very well. The rub chubbies. It's turned into a bark. Smoke with salt, spices. Very good. Anybody can make a brisket. The trick is, there's different ways to do it, but the way I do it is about 225 to 250 indirect heat. Keep your fire on one side of the pit, smoke go across, meat over here, smokestack over there, just keep that heat and smoke coming across it for a number of hours. I don't know how many hours. I go by, I use a temperature thermometer, but I didn't foil it either. Man, I'm gonna have another piece. That was good. I didn't foil it. I cooked it till it got about 190. Pulled it out of there, just brought it in here, threw it in a, put it on a baking sheet, just let it sit all night. And that's what you end up with. I had to reheat it up a little bit to make the fat flow again. But all in all, this is good. All right, folks, that's it. Sorry, Cowboy fans. The way it goes, get rid of Jerry Jones, everything will be better. Alright, almost New Year's. I got a prime rib, y'all. Out my deep freeze, gotta thaw it out, and then that's gonna be next on the agenda. So, until next time, God bless you, and hasta luego. Bye-bye.